Thanks, John. Coming up in sports, Penn State women's volleyball is riding an 8-match win streak. We'll take a look at the man behind 35 years of unparalleled success in a one-on-one interview. And Penn State football has quite the test tomorrow night in Columbus. We'll preview their matchup against 4th-ranked Ohio State. Tomorrow night, all eyes will be on the horseshoe. Penn State and Ohio State getting set for a primetime matchup under the lights. This game is without a doubt the Big Ten game of the week, and for the Nittany Lions, they look to end Ohio State's 19-game winning streak. Undefeated Ohio State, a Penn State team 2 weeks removed from a 4-OT win over Michigan, this game has all the makings of a matchup that could go down to the wire. But for Penn State to have a shot, they have to somehow make some big plays against that tough Buckeye defense.
This is the most athletic defense that we've played. They have guys on that side of the ball that are well coached. I think Luke Fickell, Mike Vrabel, those guys do a real good job of getting these guys lined up in different looks, and it's a very challenging defense.
The Buckeyes boast a solid defense, but let's not forget about the offense and the man under center that leads this Ohio State team.
It's a very difficult challenge playing a guy like Braxton Miller. In my opinion, one of the top 5 players in the country, really good football player.
Tomorrow night's showdown in Columbus kicks off at 8 p.m. Penn State football not the only team turning some heads in Happy Valley. Penn State men's soccer, they're coming off of a double overtime win at 14th-ranked Michigan State. The guys find themselves atop the Big Ten standings with 2 conference games remaining. Led by head coach Bob Warming, the men sit at 4-0 in the Big Ten with a home match against Northwestern just 2 days away. Sunday's game, a big opportunity for another win, but what can the guys not afford to do?
Not overlook them, because no opponent right now we should overlook. It's day-by-day process and game-by-game process, so I think that we need to bring the same energy that we've been bringing for the past couple of games.
The Nittany Lions are off to their best Big Ten start since 2005 and need one more point to claim at least a share of their second straight regular season title.
Last year we won the Big Ten, and this year again we have the chance to do it again, so a nice two-peat sounds pretty good right now.
Sunday's game versus Northwestern starts at 1 o'clock. Now over at Rec Hall, Penn State women's volleyball is having another sensational season. Ranked number 2 in the country, only 1 Big Ten loss, 8-match win streak, the list goes on and on. So what keeps them in the national title hunt year in and year out? Look no further than head coach Russ Rose. Here's Rachel White with that story.
He's incredibly demanding to work for, but the great ones are.
Assistant coach Steve Aird has known Russ Rose for more than 15 years.
The reason Penn State volleyball's been so good is that the school and the community has allowed him to be him.
Rose agrees.
I think I was very fortunate that I had Tim Curley as my athletic director for as long as I did, and Dr. Spanier, because I think the greatest years that we had in women's volleyball was with their leadership. Most important, they allowed me to be who I am.
And what he is a no-nonsense guy. He's incredibly charismatic. He cares about his players a ton, but he demands the most from them.
That's the essence of coaching and teaching, is trying to get people to do things that at the start of the day they don't really want to do.
He's demanding, but he's built hundreds of lifelong relationships along the way.
When I look at the pictures and I look at the people, I look at what I said to them when they were being recruited, and I look at the relationships that I have with some of them now.
But coaching champions for 35 years comes with a steep price.
I missed seeing all 4 of my children grow up, but I think if I would have done that, we wouldn't have had the success, because I was the only one that's always cared for 35 years. I spent the last 35 years with other people's children.
And many are grateful for his sacrifice.
No matter what he would get into, I think he would be exceptional at it. He just happens to be a hell of a volleyball coach.
Coach Rose continues to move up the NCAA Division I wins list. He sits in 2nd with over 1,100 wins, just behind Dave Shoji of Hawaii. Reporting from Rec Hall, I'm Rachel White for the Center County Report.
Penn State volleyball now getting into the meat of their conference schedule, but on the ice, Penn State men's hockey, they're just getting started. They were in Colorado Springs this past weekend to face Air Force, but lost both games to fall to 1-2. The Lions were outscored 8-3 in those 2 losses, but something was definitely learned from the road trip.
A very good learning experience for us, I think, and I mean, it definitely kind of refocused us. We're putting in a lot of work right now, because we know now where we got to be and where we got to be to compete at this level.
Penn State has the opportunity to rebound tonight at home as the Lions return to Pagola for the first time since the season opener. Tonight's matchup is against RIT, a team they beat on the road a season ago. But this time around, Penn State will get to see RIT on their home ice. Now looking back, a lot of hype surrounded the season opener at Pagola, and the guys do believe they will see a similar atmosphere tonight.
Yeah, I think the energy is still going to be there. It's still going to be easy to play in front of that many people, and I think everybody's going to be excited and ready to go.
Tonight's non-conference matchup starts at 7 o'clock. Now, a look around Center County High School football heating up as the district playoffs approach. Now, State College, they're one game back of first place in the Mid-Penn Commonwealth. They'll take on Mifflin County on the road at 7 o'clock tonight. Now, the Mountain District, they're tight as well. Tyrone has a chance to lock up a home playoff game when they host Penns Valley tonight. And Bald Eagle, they're in the thick of things as well. They match up against Belfont in a virtual must-win for the Eagles. Now, Phillipsburg Osceola, they're out of the hunt, but the opportunity to play spoiler tonight against unbeaten Clearfield. That's it for sports. We'll be back with more Center County Report after the break.